Hello learners, welcome to the wonderful world of English language classroom. Learners, we have been doing some listening in the last three episodes, three lessons. So, we will continue to do the series Learning to Listen and Listening to Learn. This is meant for secondary classes, that is classes 9 and 10. This is lesson 4 in the series. So, learners, today also we will do some listening. But differently, you listen to some stories, then answer some of the questions, informative questions, inferential questions. Nothing to worry, we will have some wonderful stories hereafter. Fine. Learners, to do this with me are Divyansh and Devayani.
Hello. Hello.
Then learners, with you, we all together do listening today and learning to listen, listening to learn. So, learners, we have seen in the last three episodes, three lessons, sentence dictation and paragraph dictation and mutual dictation. Come on, Divyansh and Devayani, tell me in the three lessons we did some kind of dictation kind of exercise.
We did like sentence dictation and paragraph.
Dictation, fine. And also you did mutually.
Yes.
Yeah, we discussed fine. In a group and created, recreated a story in our own language.
Oh, very good. That's good. Learners, you also have done it. Now, tell me one point on how to listen. How to listen to when somebody gives instruction, some radio talk or television news, listening. I'm talking about listening. One point, one should be clear. Tell the learners what is it. What is that?
We should not listen to the words, but a whole chunk of it.
Yes.
And we should read top to bottom. And there is a difference between listening top to bottom and bottom to top. And we should listen to the meaning of it.
Very good.
Instead of the words.
Well done. This is what learners listen to the meaning of it. When I speak here, learning to listen, listening to learn, you actually get that, I'm going to learn to listen. That's first thing. Okay. Learners, Devayani and Divyansh, let's know the objectives of this lesson for the benefit of learners and you, everyone. Learners, at the end of this lesson, we will be able to listen to comprehend a story, a factual audio or talk, and interpret them. Then second objective, having listened to a story, we infer meaning and extrapolate. Sometimes, what is the message of the story? Message, what have you learnt from this listening? So, that is what extrapolation and you interpret it. Then, we also learn to listen. There is another audio of short audio, how to listen to audios. So, that is also there. Learners, let's do some wonderful activities today. So, it is also challenging to you learners. You are going to listen to a story with some images appearing. Not the whole story will be appearing in images, but audio, you listen to the audio carefully. Here is the audio for you.
Do you know who a tinker is? Tinker does metal work and repairs household utensils. He is a traveling man who repairs metal objects. Shyam repaired pots and pans for a living. He was a tinker. One day, a poor woman asked him to repair a broken tapeli, the saucepan. Shyam refused to accept the woman's money. She gave him an old kettle. That night, Shyam cleaned the kettle with a piece of cloth and found the following words on it. I will pour whatever I am told. Silver dwells coins of gold. But only he whose heart is kind will from my spout true treasure find. Shyam was delighted. Pour out gold coins, he called to the kettle. At once, a shower of gold coins came out of the kettle spout. With the money, Shyam bought nice clothes, a house for himself and presents for his friends. They wanted to know where the money came from. Afraid that they would argue with one another over the money, Shyam kept the secret to himself. Now he stopped doing any work. His life became boring. Soon he found himself thinking more and more about his life as a tinker. "I was happier then as a tinker," he told himself. "I will return to my old trade and do tinkering." After giving away his house and the money to people who needed them, he left the town and he hid the kettle in the bushes. A few months later, Shyam passed the spot where he had left the kettle. Inside, it was a nest. Three baby sparrows were chirping happily as their mother fed them with worms. Shyam smiled to himself. The kettle was serving a better purpose. He was very happy, working hard from early morning to late evening. He had bought himself a new house, and though it was small, he was comfortable. The people too, to whom he had given away his old house, clothes and riches, were well settled and happy. Shyam went on his way with a feeling of joy and fulfillment. That's why he enjoyed a good night's sleep every night. He had truly found a treasure from the spout of the kettle.
You have listened to the story. How was the story?
Yeah, it was nice.
It was fine, fine. I should not ask how was the story. Every story is good. No? Fine. However, now, here are some questions for you. Some of them are multiple choice questions. Some of them are true or false. So, we may listen to this again, but first let's attempt the questions. So, what did Shyam ask the kettle to do first? Here are the three options. He asked the kettle to pour out coins. He asked for clothes for his friends. He asked for gifts for his friends.
He asked the kettle to pour out coins.
Very good, very good. That's good. Yay. Learners, you also check it out. The second one. Why did Shyam stop doing any work? A. Because he had got the kettle which gave him gold coins. B. Because he did not like to work. C. Because he had his land and house.
A. Because he had the kettle which gave him gold coins.
Okay. But nobody knew, but he knew that. So, he had to stop working because the kettle was giving everything. Learners, check it out, your answers. Then the third one, why did Shyam feel bored? A. Because he did not go for his tinkering work. B. Because he felt bored of his tinkering work. C. He had lot of gold coins.
Because he did not go for his tinkering work.
So he felt bad. Okay. Learners, check it out, your answers. Fourth question, why did Shyam say, I was happy as a tinker? The options are A. He felt boring without doing his tinkering work. He felt he was happy with getting money from the kettle. He did not like to do any work.
Option A. He felt boring without doing his tinkering work.
Fine. Very good. Very good. Okay. Learners, check it out. They have given all right answers. You may have got wrong. Nothing to worry. We will listen to it again after another activity. Here is the activity. Here are some 7-8 statements, Divyans and Devyani, and of course the learners. I am going to read out. You will have to say whether the statement is true or false. Shyam was a blacksmith.
The statement is false.
So, what was Shyam then?
Shyam was a tinker.
Okay. Learners, the first one, whether Shyam was a blacksmith, that is false. Okay. Shyam was not happy before he got the kettle. True or false?
False. He was happy as a tinker.
Okay. He was happy as a tinker. Learners, Shyam was not happy before he got the kettle is false because he was happy. Fine. an old lady gave him the kettle. True or false?
The statement is true.
Because she gave him. Fine. Number three, an old lady gave him the kettle is true. Fine. Four, Shyam bought clothes, house and many more things for himself and his friends. Is it true or false?
Yes, it is true. He bought clothes and house for himself and his friends.
Very good. How did he get the money?
By selling the gold coins.
Of the which was given by the kettle. Fine, fine. Shyam was very happy after he got his kettle from the woman. True or false?
The statement is true. Shyam was happy when he got the kettle.
Because he didn't know what it was going to give him. Fine. Alright, true. Sixth statement, learners. Shyam started suspecting him to know where the money came from.
It's false.
It's false. How do you say?
Because it is not mentioned in
It's not mentioned in the story, but Shyam thought to himself.
Yes, yeah.
Fine. Alright. Shyam was happy as a tinker.
The statement is true. Shyam was happy as a tinker.
Very good, very good. Okay, learners, this is the story. I'm happy that all the responses are right. Even if you don't get it right, nothing to worry. We can listen to it. We are learning language. We are learning to listen. So, there are lots of trialing and error. So, most language learning taking place by committing mistakes, errors, nothing to worry. And let us do it again, learners. Now, we are going to play the audio again, listen to it carefully. Then I'm going to ask the questions to Divyans and Devyani again. They will answer on your behalf. You can check it out. So listen to it again.
Shyam repaired pots and pans for a living. He was a tinker. One day, a poor woman asked him to repair a broken tapeli, the saucepan. Shyam refused to accept the woman's money. She gave him an old kettle. That night, Shyam cleaned the kettle with a piece of cloth and found the following words on it. I will pour whatever I am told, silver, jewels, coins of gold, but only he whose heart is kind will from my spout true treasure find. Shyam was delighted. Pour out gold coins, he called to the kettle. At once, a shower of gold coins came out of the kettle's spout. With the money, Shyam bought nice clothes, a house for himself and presents for his friends. They wanted to know where the money came from. Afraid that they would argue with one another over the money, Shyam kept the secret to himself. Now he stopped doing any work. His life became boring. Soon he found himself thinking more and more about his life as a tinker. I was happier then as a tinker, he told himself. I will return to my old trade and do tinkering. After giving away his house and the money to people who needed them, he left the town and he hid the kettle in the bushes. A few months later, Shyam passed the spot where he had left the kettle. Inside, it was a nest. Three baby sparrows were chirping happily as their mother fed them with worms. Shyam smiled to himself. The kettle was serving a better purpose. He was very happy, working hard from early morning to late evening. He had bought himself a new house, and though it was small, he was comfortable. The people too, to whom he had given away his old house, clothes and riches, were well settled and happy. Shyam went on his way with a feeling of joy and fulfillment. That's why he enjoyed a good night's sleep every night. He had truly found a treasure from the spout of the kettle.
So, learners, let's check it out, the whole story. I'm going to read out the true or false statements, and Divyans and Divyani will answer on your behalf. You also can do that. Okay, I'm going to read out. You need not now say true or false. You have to say yes or correct the sentence. Let's begin with the first statement. Shyam was a blacksmith.
Shyam was a tinker, not a blacksmith.
But blacksmith. Okay, agreed, learners. Then Shyam was not happy before he got the kettle.
No, he was happy as a tinker.
Okay, he was very happy. Yes. So learners, noted. An old lady gave him the kettle. True.
Yes.
Yeah, she gave him. Why did she give him?
She gave him the kettle as he was very a nice man and he didn't took any money.
Oh yeah, he refused to take money from her. Okay, she gave it. Okay. Shyam bought clothes, house and many more things for himself and friends.
Yes.
True, because fine, all right. So, Shyam was very happy after he got the kettle from the woman.
Yes.
Yes.
He was happy when he got.
So, when he became sad?
He became sad when he thought that my tinker job was
giving better.
It was better and now I am bored.
Okay, all right, fine. Shyam's friends started suspecting him to know where the money came from.
No, he was his friends wasn't suspecting anything, but he thought by himself. He was suspecting himself only.
Okay, that whether the friends would think that that I was getting money from somewhere else. Yeah. So was Shyam happy as a tinker?
Yes, he was happy as a tinker.
Fine, learners, you got it. Thank you very much. This is a story, so listening is easier because the story moves from one event to another event, the characters move. But sometimes when you listen to scientific descriptions, chemistry reaction, experiment, so we have to be very carefully listening to what happens first, what happens next, how things move around. Fine. Learners, Divyans and Divyani, we are going to listen to an audio on how to listen anything. So here it is, let's listen, and the summary of it also appears on your screen in text. Come on, let's listen to the audio.
Listening is crucial to language acquisition because it provides comprehensible input. Comprehensible input refers to meaningful oral and written language, somewhat above the learner's current level of mastery. Such input allows for the acquisition of grammar and vocabulary, which in turn makes additional input more comprehensible. Mere exposure to language is insufficient. Learners must take notice of key features of the language to get the maximum benefit out of it. How do we comprehend spoken language? One model is called bottom-up approach. According to this view, we piece together a message by first understanding the smallest units of language, that is, sounds. Then we hear the sound sequences together to form words. Our knowledge of words enables us to understand phrases and sentences and finally an entire passage. An alternative view is known as top-down approach. In this model, based on our knowledge of the topic and situation, we can figure out the specific meaning of a passage and the sentences, phrases, and words that form the message. Current thinking suggests an interactive model in which listeners simultaneously use both top-down and bottom-up strategies. One strategy compensates for the gaps in the other until the entire message is understood. You are aware that there are many types of listening. Sometimes we listen for the general meaning of a message and sometimes for specific information. At times, listening is a one-way process, a lecture or a movie. And at other times, it is a two-way process and involves both listening and speaking, as in a piece of conversation. Sometimes, listening entails mainly information exchange. At other times, listening may be social or emotional, in which feelings are more prominent. Now, as practicing teachers, how can we promote listening as a skill in language learning among children? What strategies should we adopt to realize the maximum from listening activities? Let us explore what strategies could work in our classrooms. Try and design your own strategies that suit the local contexts. Here are some tips for you. Before administering a listening task, ask students what they know about the topic so that they can recall their prior knowledge. A teacher may also preview vocabulary and ideas prior to listening. Following the listening, ask students about the general points of the passage. If details are to be recalled, allow students to take notes or work through the handout if provided. Use natural language for a listening passage. It is better to use short pieces of real language at the initial level than artificial teacher-made language. Use a variety of listening activities, such as one-way and two-way processes, through various texts. You may chalk out your own strategy for using the audio materials. Ask the students to work in pairs, small groups, or individually, and play the audio more than once or even many times to enhance children's learning. If they take time to complete one task followed by listening, repeat playing so that they can understand it fully.
Learners, we have listened to the audio twice, then we have answered, worked out some activities. So what did the multiple choice questions and the true or false questions do to you? So it was trying to make you recall what you have listened to. It made you engage with the text, the audio listened to. So you must, when you read something, try some activities which will engage you in the reading text or whatever you listen to. There are lots of things nowadays, lots of FM radio in English, in Hindi, in our languages. So that you try. And there are some of the ways we can improve our listening. Here are some for you. Listen to All India Radio News. I am saying All India Radio News and Doordarshan News because their presentation is not hyped, they are very neutral, so listen to those. And other one, NCERT has lots of audio available on e-Pathshala and National Repository of Open Educational Resources, that is NROER, and Diksha portal of Government of India's. You can listen to it. Thank you very much. Before we close, let's learn the learning outcomes of this lesson. We have only one learning outcome addressed. So, we expect you learners, we have learnt from this to listen to, comprehend your story, announcements, instructions in audio form or in face-to-face form, and understand the facts and interpret the ideas and infer ideas based on the listening. Thank you learners, thank you Divyans, and thank you Divyani for having participated in the classroom.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.